Fans always hoped that the cast of Glee were just as full of glee Offset, but the show has been beset by controversies, tragic events, and shocking revelations. Keep watching to discover the full extent of Mark Salling's disturbing past. Are you new to our channel? Hit that subscribe button to see more videos like this. But for now, let's take a look at 10 Dark Secrets from the cast of Glee. Guilt over Cory Monteith. The cast of Glee, and the rest of the world, was in mourning when news of Cory Monteith's passing was announced in July 2013. Although Cory, who played Finn Hudson, had been open about his history of substance abuse, it still shocked many, especially when the autopsy later revealed he passed away from an overdose. The cast paid tribute to Cory in a special episode and spoke out publicly about their love for him. But some cast members also admitted they had feelings of guilt about Cory's tragic end. Naya Rivera, who played high school cheerleader Santana Lopez in Glee, wrote about her guilt in the 2016 memoir Sorry Not Sorry, Dreams, Mistakes, and Growing Up. She admitted that she doubts she's alone in feeling a lot of regret about his death. Naya added that since Cory died, a lot of the cast have spent time wondering and talking about what would have happened if someone had stepped in or confronted him about what was going on. Or what if he'd been trying to talk to someone about what was going on and just thought no one cared? She wondered if she had walked more slowly to her car one night, then perhaps he would have had the opportunity to open up to her. The actress added, "You can drive yourself crazy like that, because no number of ifs will ever make anything different." Naya Rivera's domestic battery charge. Naya Rivera has been caught up in quite a few controversies. One of the most recent occurred during Thanksgiving weekend 2017 in West Virginia, and it involved her husband Ryan Dorsey accusing her of domestic battery. Naya was arrested on November 25th on suspicion of domestic violence. She allegedly hit Ryan in the head during a walk with their two-year-old son, Josie. Ryan made a call to 911 claiming Naya was out of control. He declined medical attention for the head and lip injuries he sustained during the altercation. Police believed Naya was intoxicated at the time. Ryan went on to ask for privacy in a statement on Twitter, calling it a difficult time for everyone in the family. Soon after she was arrested, Naya filed for divorce from Ryan. This was the second time she had done so. The actress had previously filed for divorce in November 2016, but dismissed it in October 2017. In late December, the couple agreed to share custody of their son. Then in January 2018, Ryan dropped the domestic battery charges against Naya. It was reported that he didn't want to move forward with pressing charges. It's not just Offset that Naya's been involved in disagreements, though, as we'll see in our next entry. Lea Michele and Naya Rivera's feud. With so many young actors in one room, it's inevitable that some of them aren't going to get on. But on the set of Glee, the tensions reached pretty high levels, to the point where certain cast members stopped speaking to each other. Talk about awkward. You might have heard the rumors that Lea Michele and Naya Rivera had a feud that reached epic proportions. Well, Naya herself addressed this dark secret and gave her side of the story in her 2016 memoir. Naya wrote about her relationship with Lea. She started off by admitting that her and Lea are really similar. Both are strong-willed and competitive, not just with each other, but with everyone. Naya saw parallels between the actress's relationship and their character's relationship. The character's friendship started to break down as the show progressed, especially as Santana moved from a background character to one with bigger plot lines and more screen time. And Naya reckons that Lea didn't like sharing the spotlight. Naya added that she wasn't offended when people offered feedback or criticism, whereas Lea was a lot more sensitive. Naya felt that Lea blamed her for anything and everything that went wrong. Eventually, Lea started to ignore Naya, to the point where she didn't say a word to her for all of season 6. Despite admitting that Lea and her friend definitely weren't the best of friends, Naya believes the rumors of their feud were blown out of proportion. So many feuds. It wasn't just Lea and Naya who were feuding on set, though. The show's co-creator Ryan Murphy not only opened up about the actresses in a 2017 interview with E! News, he also spilled on other feuds that went under the radar. Ryan was promoting his latest series, FX's Feud, so it makes sense that he was asked if he'd ever consider doing a feud season on the Glee starlets. He took the opportunity to open up about the on-set tensions. Ryan admitted that Glee was a storm of difficulty, largely because what do you do when you're 18 years old? Old or 19 years old, and you wake up one day and you're world famous. Ryan believes that a lot of that difficulty was informed by the cast's youth and being involved in a phenomenon. As for Lea and Naya, Ryan said he knew for a fact that the actresses admired each other's work, and he wouldn't include their feud on his new show because it would have to have decades of pain behind it. If the pair were still feuding at 40, though, he'd consider it. But then came Ryan's big reveal, which was that there were many boys on our show that didn't get along, and you never hear about that. You never hear about that in our culture. Aren't you just aching to know which guys had feuds? Please, Ryan, tell us more. Diana Agron's no-show. When fans were looking for a potential feud on set, they pointed their attention in the direction of Diana Agron. Diana was notable by her absence during the show's Cory Monteith tribute episode that aired in October 2013, called The Quarterback. Fans thought Diana should have been involved, particularly because she played Quinn, who was Corey's character Finn's first girlfriend on Glee. And so when she wasn't a part of it, the rumor mill went into overdrive. There were reports of a bitter rift between Diana and the rest of the cast. In particular, Ryan Murphy and Lea Michele were said to intensely dislike her. However, other reports claimed that Diana was still a part of the Glee family. It remains a mystery as to exactly why Diana wasn't in the episode. Ryan said he put anyone who wanted to be in the episode in it. And when he was asked why Diana was absent, he replied, "I think she was working. I don't know." In an interview with the Irish Independent that appeared the next month, Diana didn't specifically address what kept her away from the episode. She did, however, talk about how she had nothing but love for that show and everybody involved in it. As she was no longer on set anymore, she found the rumors even more heartbreaking than if she was there with everybody, and it made her feel even farther away from the show. Heather Morris's baby shower snubbed. Speaking of being notably absent, there was another occasion when Glee actresses weren't where they were expected to be. Fans were disappointed when it appeared that the cast wasn't as close as they led everyone to believe, and that was because the guest list at a certain cast member's baby shower was noticeably lacking most of her co-stars. When Heather Morris, who played Brittany Pierce, held her baby shower in 2013, hardly any of the female cast made it to the event. Naya Rivera and Vanessa Lungis did make it to the celebration, but Amber Riley, Diana Agron, and Lea Michele were no-shows. It led to conspiracy theories that the actresses weren't as close as they made out. A little deeper digging discovered that Lea was on vacation in Cabo at the time, and Diana was also out of the country. Amber was laid up on antibiotics, so perhaps they all were invited but just couldn't go because of these other commitments or circumstances. But those conspiracy theorists preferred the suggestion that the trio either weren't welcome or refused to go. Jane Lynch's cold medicine addiction. Glee fans will always think of Jane Lynch as Sue Sylvester, and the actress shared with those fans, as well as the rest of the world, some of her dark secrets in her 2011 memoir, Happy Accidents. She wrote honestly about her struggle with alcoholism and addiction, and when she gave up drinking in 1991, she turned to two other substances. One was huge amounts of chocolate ice cream, which she ate daily to replace the copious amounts of sugar her body was used to from her daily beer intake. And the other was cough syrup. It was NyQuil medication that she became addicted to. She explained that she continued her habit of taking NyQuil before bed because she was still in need of something to soothe herself. She admits that at the time, she did not acknowledge the fact that NyQuil had alcohol in it. She still considered herself on the wagon. After her addiction grew when she moved from Chicago to New York, Jane eventually found her way to Alcoholics Anonymous in 1992. On the release of her memoir in 2011, she was able to say she'd been sober for those 20 years ever since. Naya Rivera's termination. Naya Rivera revealed quite a few secrets in her memoir. In the book, she revealed for the first time that she had a termination in late 2010. She found out she was pregnant just weeks after breaking up with Ryan Dorsey. She chose to focus on her career at the time and did not share the news with him. Naya terminated the pregnancy during a day off from filming Glee. The pair later went on to marry in 2014 and have son Josie, but as we've already seen, their relationship came to an end in late 2017. The actress opened up to People magazine about her concerns surrounding the revelations in her memoir. She admitted it was very scary to open up about everything. The actress added that it's not something a lot of people talk about, but she thinks they should. She hoped that someone out there gets something out of it. Naya received some backlash after her past went public, so she took to Twitter to address the news. She tweeted that she set out to write a book that was true to herself and would hopefully help others along the way. She added that she hoped others would respect her good intentions in sharing her stories with the world. One of those people she wants it to help is her own son. Naya revealed that she hopes Josie will read it one day. That's because she hopes it will give him a better perspective on the issues women face. Mark Salling's battery charge. Mark Salling, who played Noah Puck Puckerman, was sued by former flame Roxanne Gorzella for battery. The Playboy model filed a lawsuit in January 2013, claiming Mark did not use protection, which was against her wishes. She said she had clearly not consented to continue the act unprotected. Mark responded by claiming that Roxanne was equally negligent and did not exercise ordinary care on her own behalf. In a court filing in April 2013, he argued that she voluntarily placed herself in a position of danger and exposure to such injuries and damages, if any. Roxanne said the incident caused her great anxiety. She alleged that Mark ignored her request to discuss his history of unprotected acts and STD testing. Roxanne claimed that when she went to speak with him about her health concerns, they had a verbal confrontation. This ended with Mark pushing her to the ground and injuring her head and knees. She added that she suffered severe injuries to her person and psyche, for which she has and will continue to sustain medical expenses, loss of income, pain and suffering, and emotional distress. Mark, on the other hand, claimed Roxanne broke down his door and violently attacked him before damaging his car. Mark eventually settled in March 2015. The actor was ordered to pay Roxanne $2.7 million. Mark Salling's conviction. Mark Salling passed away at the age of 35 in January 2018. His lawyer released a statement confirming the news, adding that the actor was doing his best to atone for some serious mistakes and errors of judgment. At the time, Mark was facing up to 7 years in prison after pleading guilty to possession of child abuse images. The actor had been arrested in December 2015. He was later indicted in May 2016 on charges of receiving and possessing disturbing images of children significantly under the age of 15 or 16. A search warrant had led to the discovery of more than 50,000 images on his computer and flash drive. He pleaded guilty in October 2017 in a plea agreement, which meant he would serve 4 to 7 years in prison rather than the maximum sentence of 20 years. His sentencing was scheduled for March 7th. Mark was also ordered to register as a sex offender and to pay each of his victims $50,000. His ex-girlfriend and former Glee co-star, Naya Rivera, commented on the charges in her 2016 memoir. She admitted that she couldn't say she was totally shocked by the news. Which of these dark secrets do you find the most shocking? Let us know in the comments section below and give this video a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.